First, Internet Explorer 4.0. You'll see differences on your desktop before you even get to the browser. For example, all your icons will be single-click instead of double-click. You'll be able to drag and drop these icons right onto the Windows Start Bar. If you right-click the Active Desktop feature, you'll notice that Microsoft is taking the idea of wallpaper to a new level, allowing you to run everything from ActiveX controls to web pages right on your desktop.
Not only is the suite do everything you need on the web, but it starts to get into your operating system and make your desktop, for example, look and act like it's on the web, which is pretty cool, actually, if you don't mind your OS being taken over by IE.
Once you get into Microsoft's new browser, you'll notice that the keyword here is customizing. You can switch all the buttons around on the toolbar. You can subscribe to sites in your bookmark folder so the browser can update information as it changes, and even surf offline using pages your computer already has stored in its memory. Internet Explorer 4.0 also builds in the capacity for pushing information you decide on right to your desktop. They've also revamped search features by including a handy people search function and a new design which splits the page and offers compressed results. Microsoft isn't the only one reinventing their look. Netscape has a few new toys and tricks up their sleeve with Communicator. A new toolbar lets you flip between different parts of Communicator, reminding you that you're working with a whole new suite, not just a browser. Netscape messaging for newsgroups and email, Composer to begin writing your own web pages, Conference to dial across the web, and Collabora for intergroup communication. The browser itself has been redesigned to be much more user-friendly.
Netscape, for example, with the back button has a really cool thing where instead of just clicking the back button to go back a page, you can do that, or you can hold it down and it displays a list of everything that you've been to for the last session.
The toolbars are all collapsible, giving the user more room to see what's important. You can drag bookmarks right onto your personal toolbar, and searching is even easier now, because all you have to do is type what you want into the location bar, and the search automatically starts up. And by supporting dynamic HTML, a language that helps web developers animate pages much faster, these browsers hope to literally change the way you see the web.
So the big fundamental change in these products, which is a trend that these kind of illustrate, is the change in computer programs from being about the program, about the interface, to being about the information.
Okay, Hari, these are some really interesting things, but just this weekend I spent hours trying to download this browser with so many bells and whistles and features, I don't think I'm even going to use them all.
Well, I don't spend my weekends downloading browsers, but it is true, when you go to Netscape's site, they allow users to pick the type of browser package that they want because there are a lot of features that you might not use. Microsoft's isn't available yet, but they'll probably package it the same way. So you got to check which bells and whistles you want before you press download.
Good advice. And before you take the plunge on any of the new browsers, be sure to check out CNET's new section, Browser Central. I wish I had. We've brought all of our best browser-related information from all of our sites into one place. There you'll find tips, reviews, news, and free downloads. Coming up next, AOL goes international, and the Star Wars trilogy blasts its way onto your desktop.
Net News is sponsored by IBM, solutions for a small planet.
In this week's Net News, America Online is taking Japan online, launching a Japanese version of its service April 15th. It's just the newest of AOL's international rollouts. AOL Japan will have the same features as the English version, but will have locally produced news and interactive programming. It'll cost $8 a month for 3 hours, $4 for each added hour. Disney's adding to its online presence with a new web amusement park of sorts. It's a new pay service for kids called Disney's Daily Blast. Members of Microsoft Network can access the service for free if they're running Windows 95. It doesn't run on Macintosh yet. It'll cost $5 a month for the general public. Daily Blast is aimed at kids age 3 to 12 with interactive comic strips, coloring books, games, and downloadable digital toys. Database king Larry Ellison says he's just the man to alleviate the troubles ailing Apple Computer. Oracle CEO now has a reported bid in the offing to take over the company. Ellison set up an email box to get outside feedback on the potential takeover. He wants to know what you think about Apple's management and business strategy. You can email him at savapple@us.oracle.com. Legislators on Capitol Hill are up in arms over a looming technical disaster that could hit at the year 2000. They're asking federal agencies to investigate the potential damage of what's being called the Millennium Bug. It could cause some computers and household and commercial appliances to go haywire. The problem is some chips and software will misread the date 2000 as 1900, causing some systems to scramble. Congress wants to determine what can be done to avoid the crisis. Big news about those long-awaited digital TVs. Their shipment to store shelves has been delayed a year. Digital TV makers were planning on rolling out high-definition televisions by 1998. It's now postponed until 99 because the nation's TV broadcasters, such as ABC, NBC, and CBS, are now saying they will not air anything significant in digital before then. And most local TV stations are not expected to have their digital equipment until after the year 2000. To get more on these stories and stay up to date on all the daily developments of the digital world, you'll want to make sure to visit CNetsNews.com.
Thanks, Richard. Now, keeping you up to date in this rapidly changing digital world is our job here at CNET Central. And that includes answering some of your most frequently asked questions or facts. And here with some of the answers is our own Sofie Formica.
Thanks, Gina. Well, with all the new technologies appearing each week on the internet, it can get a bit confusing out there, and that brings us to this week's question from Garth Carl of Canada. He writes, what is ActiveX and how is it used on the web? Well, Garth, essentially ActiveX is a technology developed by Microsoft that enables programmers to create dynamic interactive web pages, and this is how it works. Developers pack tiny programs into what are called ActiveX controls, which are like tiny envelopes that contain special instructions for your browser. When you come across a page that's been activated, like this site by ImageFX, your browser reads the instructions in the ActiveX controls, then displays things like a scrolling banner or rotating text. Besides bringing text to life, ActiveX controls can do things like move shapes or animate characters. And beyond animation, some controls like Look at Me allow you to view another person's computer screen anywhere in the world. Not surprisingly, ActiveX works best with Microsoft's Internet Explorer browser in a Windows environment, but if you use Netscape Navigator, you can also download a plugin that lets you view some ActiveX-enabled web pages. I should also mention that Microsoft has been in the news lately for security problems involving ActiveX, but they are addressing these issues and have already released some fixes. Now, if you're confused by any of the terms or technologies that are featured here on CNET Central, of course, we want to help.
Yeah, that's right. Send your question to thefactfile@cnet.com or through regular or snail mail to The Fact File, 150 Chestnut Street, San Francisco, California, 94111. And if you want to know more about ActiveX, head on over to cnet.com. You'll also find those Fact File addresses and each week's question and answer.
Stay with us. Just ahead, Desmond shows us some new CD-ROMs that play movies right in your computer, if you know where to find them. And a sneak peek at the latest from LucasArts.